The Union Textile Minister Dayanidhi Maran, who's issued a legal notice to Tehelka magazine and said that he calls the report actually a blatant lie under the pretext of investigative journalism. We have Tamanna with us in the Mumbai News Pit with more details. Tamanna, give us the details.
Well, Harshi, here I have in my hand the legal notice which Dayanidhi Maran issued late last night to Tehelka magazine after their cover story on him. Now, in this notice, he goes on to say, and as you mentioned, some portions of it, he says it's a blatant and concocted lie under the pretext of investigative journalism, which has appeared in your magazine. He says they're totally false, baseless, defamatory, derogatory charges which have been published with a malified intention and ulterior motive to defame my client. This is, of course, sent by his lawyers to Tehelka magazine. He goes on to say the sum and substance of the false and frivolous allegations against my client, he's really basically slamming the entire report. He says that the entire allegation that the minister deliberately delayed clearing the application made by Aircel for licenses is completely incorrect, which was the core of the entire Tehelka report. Now, I also have Navika Kumar with me. Now, Navika, late last evening, Dayanidhi Maran met the Prime Minister for about 45 minutes, and it was believed that the core of the conversation did center around this Tehelka report.
Well, Tamanna, from what we understand, Dayanidhi Maran was part of the Cabinet Committee on Political Affairs meeting, following which, of course, we understand that there was a one-on-one meeting between the Prime Minister and Dayanidhi Maran. However, we are not getting any confirmation at this point from either Mr. Maran or the Prime Minister's office on what the issue really was that was discussed. But clearly, given the fact that Mr. Dayanidhi Maran also met with Sonia Gandhi along with his cabinet colleague M.K. Alagiri last week, it is raising eyebrows on what really was the topic of discussion. And there is speculation that the entire issue of his role in handing over the entire contract to Aircel only after Maxis really came into the picture, that was the subject matter of discussion. However, no confirmation coming in from the Prime Minister's office as of now on this entire issue. But clearly, voices within the political establishment really growing louder at this point in time that this is yet another huge embarrassment as far as the UPA government is concerned.
Tehelka magazine has reacted to the legal notice. Well, the first part of their statement says they haven't actually received a copy of the legal notice yet, but they do go on to say that this is complete intimidation which has been seen, and this is something that they encounter often because of the kind of stories they do. It seems like a clear all-out war here, Navika, with Tehelka showing no signs, at least currently, of taking back what they say, what they have printed, or a disclaimer of any sorts.
That's right. It's a war between the media house and Dayanidhi Maran for the moment. But also the offshoot of this is the fact that there is a joint parliamentary committee which is looking into the entire 2G spectrum scam. And it is looking at the role of telecom ministers even before A. Raja. And in that context, when I happened to speak with at least three or four members of the JPC, they were very clear that Dayanidhi Maran would be summoned. It's a question of when he will be summoned. He will be summoned. And details of this entire transaction is something that Dayanidhi Maran will need to explain even to the Joint Parliamentary Commission.
New information is coming to light as a result of which new people are, suspicions are being raised about their culpability, who are currently also ministers in the cabinet. Now, in any case, the issue is such that the law must take its course, and on that there should be no demand. And whether it's the grounds on which whether people should continue or not continue in office as ministers, etc., that is a larger moral question on which no legality can be expressed. But let the law take its course. And I think going by the standards and also what the Prime Minister said on the second anniversary of the UPA 2, if he's true to what he said, then he must act on the basis of all this information and let the law take its course and take it fast.
Well, Sitaram Yechuri, with a fairly guarded response as more and more facts are yet to emerge on this entire story on the Aircel Maxis deal specifically.